إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the highest rank of Iman in Surah Allaah Imran, He said this, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. March forth, race to a forgiveness from your Lord. وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And a paradise, the width of which is the heavens and the earth, prepared for المتقين. And this is the highest rank. It's very similar to the level of ihsan. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about their attributes in that context, He said, number one, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Those who spend at times of ease and at times of distress, and they forgive people, they oppress their anger, and they are muhsins. Here is the one that I'm seeking. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about المتقين, but yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that if they commit a fahisha, والفاحشة في اللغة هي الزنا والعياذ بالله. Fahisha is adultery, something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates. But yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً. And when they commit a fahisha, here is what they do. ذَكَرُوا اللَّهِ. They remember Allah. فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ. And they asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And who can forgive sins but Allah? وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا. And they did not insist on that sin that they have committed. عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. They do not insist what they committed knowingly. يؤكد هذا المعنى قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم confirms that meaning. من حديث أنس بن مالك والحديث في سنن الترمذي قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كل ابن آدم خطاء. All the children of Adam are sinners. وخير الخطائين التوابون. And the best of those who sin are those who repent, are those who come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is another level out there. Hadith Abi Huraira fi Sahih Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam swears by Allah. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم والذي نفسي بيده, by the one in whose hand my soul is, سبحانه وتعالى, لو لم تذنبوا, if you do not commit sins, لذهب الله بكم, Allah will take you away, وأتى بقوم يذنبون فيستغفرون الله فيغفر لهم. Allah will bring other people who will sin, but with one condition, that they ask for forgiveness. They will repent, and Allah will accept their repentance. I believe my point is clear, that we are all sinners, and we're all subject to sinning. لا ينفك العبد عن ذنب أبدا أبدا. There is always something wrong that you commit, and that is why tawbah is every day, is every second. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح مسلم says, حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما, يا أيها الناس, all people, استغفروا الله وتوبوا إليه. Ask Allah to forgive you and repent. فإني أستغفر الله وأتوب إليه في اليوم 100 times. Every day, at least 100 times, I say, oh Allah, forgive me. راوي هذا الحديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما says, كنا نعد لرسول الله في المجلس الواحد أكثر من 70 times. We used to count for the Messenger of Allah in one sitting, more than 70 times. Oh Allah, forgive me and accept my repentance. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the sins that we commit جمهور أهل السنة, the multitude of the scholars of the Sunnah have divided them into two types. ومنهم من خرج عن هذا الإجماع. The issue, the multitude of the scholars divided the sins that we commit into two categories. But some of them have said sin is a sin. ولكن الجمهور على هذا القول. Major sins, minor sins, كبائر وصغائر. What are the evidence that they used to divide the sins into major and minors? In the Quran, قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِن تَجْتَنِبُوا كَبَائِرَ مَا تُنْهَوْنَ عَنْهُ نُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ. If you avoid the major things that we commanded you to avoid, we will expiate your minors, the sins. الآية العمدة في هذا الموضوع في سورة النجم. الله سبحانه وتعالى says, الذين يجتنبون كبائر الإثم والفواحش إلا اللمم. Those who avoid committing the major sins except اللمم. وهناك حديث للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو في صحيح مسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الصلوات الخمس, the five daily prayers, والجمعة إلى الجمعة, and from جمعة to the next جمعة, ورمضان إلى رمضان, and from رمضان to the next رمضان, مكفرات لما بينهن, they expiate the sins that you committed between those periods with one restrictions, with one restriction, إذا مجتنبت الكبائر, as long as you avoid committing major sins. هذا الحديث, this hadith also explains to you that the minor sins will be taken care of automatically. The sins that are considered minor in our religion, they are expiated automatically by avoiding the major, based on the ayah in Surah An-Nisa, إِن تَجْتَنِبُوا كَبَائِرَ مَا تُنْهَوْنَ عَنْهُ. If you avoid the major, نُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ, and also from the salah to the next salah. You pray dhuhr, you go out there and you commit a minor, you praying asr expiates that minor. The jum'ah that you came to today will expiate the minor that was committed between from the last jum'ah to now. Ramadan, Allahumma balighna Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends our lives to observe Ramadan. By living Ramadan, expiate the minors. So what really we should be considered, we should be worried about is the major. Is the major sins. What are the major sins? And how do you repent from them? This is something that you have to do before Ramadan if you want to have a fruitful Ramadan. And if you do not do this before Ramadan, it will be hard in Ramadan. I stress this fact again. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the scholars have given certain criteria by which you identify a major sin. Criteria number one, if the punishment of that sin is the hellfire, it's a major sin. قال الله تعالى, an example, إن الذين يأكلون أموال اليتامى ظلما. Indeed, those who take away the wealth of the orphans unjustly, إنما يأكلون في بطونهم نارا. They devour into their bellies fire. وَسَيَصْلَوْنَ سَعِيرًا, and they will go to the hellfire. So you know, if you take away the wealth of the orphan, it's a major sin from there. This is number one. A sin that the Sharia has identified a had for, it's punishable by the Sharia. قال الله تعالى, الله سبحانه وتعالى says, والسارق والسارقة فاقطعوا أيديهما. The thief, male, female, cut their hands. That's a major sin. الزانية والزاني فَاجْلِدُوا كُلَّ وَاحِدٍ مِنْهُمَا مِئَةَ جَلْدَ. The female adulteress and the male adulterer, flog them 100 times if they are not married. Sunnah, stoning to death if they are married. Again, I'm trying to give criteria, I'm not going into details. Or the text has identified this to be a major sin. Hadith Abi Bakra radiyallahu anhu, wa huwa fi sahihayn, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, atadruna man ma akbaru al-kabair? Do you know what is the major sins? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam named the shirk billah, uquq al-walidayn, wa qawlu al-zur, wa shahadatu al-zur. Yani the sunnah has compiled at least 30 sins to be major. Also, there is another criteria when Allah, when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَيْسَ مِنَّا مَنْ غَشَّنَا فَلَيْسَ مِنَّا. If you cheat us, you're not from us. لَيْسَ مِنَّا مَنْ لَطَمَ الْخُدُودِ وَشَقَّ الْجُيُوبِ وَدَعَى بِدَعْوَةِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. All of these are criterias. But here is a criteria that you should memorize. لا صغيرة مع إصرار. وهذا قول ابن عباس وإسناده صحيح. لا صغيرة مع إصرار ولا كبيرة مع استغفار. There is no such a major sin when you repent right away from it. And at the same time, there is no such a minor sin when you insist on it. Let me name some for you and you make your call. Because they could reach up to 70. Ash-shirk is a major sin. عقوق الوالدين, being undutiful to your parents, is a major shirk. Az-zina, adultery, is a major sin. Bear witnessing, false testimony, is a major sin. Riba, usury is a major sin. Tarku salah, not praying out of negligence, is a major sin. Lying, especially the white ones, are a major sin. Backbiting. Gossiping is a major sin. Slandering is a major sin. Saying Allah said, the Messenger said, unknowingly is a major sin. هكذا. Here you are. Today is the 19th of Sha'ban, or the 18th. And this is the Jum'ah before last in this month. In 12 days, Ramadan will be here. And you are guilty of one of these major sins. If you want to live a different Ramadan, you must repent from these major sins. And there is a process for this. نطبت إلى الله ورجعت إلى الله وعزمت على ألا أعود إلى المعاصي أبدا. ليست هذه التوبة. Repentance actually has pillars that must be fulfilled. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is time right now for you and me. Wallahi akhi, I'm reminding myself to come out of this. At-tawbah, the definition of tawbah is that you leave everything that displeases Allah, whether external or internal. There are sins, by the way, that are major and internal. Arrogance, pride, mahabbat ghayr Allah, you love someone other than Allah, fearing someone other than Allah, hoping in someone other than Allah. These are internal. You leave the internal sins and the external sins to the obedience of Allah. هذه التوبة. And if you do this, subhanallah, yani, I would love to use an analogy for you. You have a guest who will be arriving in 12 days and you really like that guest. What are you going to do? You're going to prepare the house, clean it, prepare his bedroom, create some itinerary. Ramadan is a guest, is coming to you in 12 days, more or less, based on the moon sighting. Are you going to prepare this heart? You see, Ramadan will reside in the heart. Fasting was prescribed for the heart. Shouldn't you clean that heart from the major sins? You must commit the tawbah, brothers and sisters in Islam. You must clear that heart. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kama fi sunan al-Tirmidhi min hadith Abi Hurayra radiyallahu anhu, he said, إِذَا أَذْنَبَ الْعَبْدُ ذَنْبًا نُكِتَ فِي قَلْبِهِ نُكْتَةٌ سَوْدَى. When you commit one of these majors, a dark stain in the heart. Now this is what you're supposed to do now. فَإِذَا تَابَ, if he repents, وَنَزَعَ, and left, وَاسْتَغْفَرْ, سُقِلَ قَلْبُ, his heart will turn into a mirror. Clean. That is the bed that you're preparing for Ramadan. Clean heart. Because the taqwa is in the heart. And Ramadan was prescribed upon you for taqwa. Ramadan is a ritual. وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. في حلية الأولياء, and listen to this, just to حديث علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says, ما من القلوب قلب إلا وله سحابة كسحابة القمر فإذا هو مضيء علته سحابة فأظلم فإذا انكشفت أضاء. Imagine your heart like a full moon, clean, full moon. There is a cloud. Imagine seeing the moon the last couple of nights. Clear sky, the moon is shining, the light is. And there is a cloud that comes, and then it would veil that moon, the light of the moon. This is the cloud of a sin, of a major sin. You must remove it for this heart to shine. Brothers and sisters in Islam, there are five conditions for your repentance from the major sins that you must have. It's not astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah when you're still doing it. It's not tubtu ilallah when you're still engaged in it. No. Five conditions that you must have in order to come out of a major sin that you are engaged in before Ramadan, in order to clean that heart. Condition number one, you must do it for Allah. Sincerity. Someone who drinks alcohol, it's a major sin. He would say, you know what, I'm not going to drink anymore because I cannot afford it. That's not tawbah. Or when I lose my mind, I become so, and that's what it does. Someone who drinks alcohol, he turns himself into, I don't want to say an animal. Animals are better because animals are governed by their instinct. Worse than animal. Somebody who is drinking alcohol, you know what? I feel so silly and people make fun at me. I'm just gonna give it up. That is not a tawbah. Or someone who is afraid, what happened if somebody in the masjid sees you? Come on. That is not a tawbah. You're repenting for Allah. You want to come back to Allah. Sincerity. Condition number one. You're not repenting for the people. وَهَذِهِ تَوْبَةٌ. This is the repentance of the losers. If you do it for the people. Because it's not going to work. It will not work. Number two. النَّدَم. Regretfulness. وَصَحَّ فِي الْمُسْنَدْ النَّدَمُ تَوْبَةٌ فِي سُنَنِ ابْنِ مَاجَةَ النَّدَمُ تَوْبَةٌ. Nadam, regretfulness is repentance. وهو أعظم ركن من أركان التوبة. And it is the greatest pillar of tawbah that you regret. When you recall the sin that you committed, mashallah, yes, I wish. If you do this, that's not tawbah. You must regret. Number three, you must give up the sin. At least at the time of repentance. You must give it up. It doesn't make any sense when you say, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, tub to Allah, when you're already having some reservation in your heart that I'm going to do it. Number four, engaging in acts of obedience. إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. وهذا يعني أمر. This is an issue. You see, you got to understand something very simple. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought for your nafs, for your life, an agenda, which is obeying Allah. Praying five daily prayers, fasting, giving sadaqah, enjoining good, forbidding evil. If you do not engage your nafs in that agenda, you know what? Your nafs has an agenda for you. Let's go drink. That's how it goes. You see, can you tell your brain, okay, my brain, stop thinking. My brain, stop thinking. Your brain will keep thinking. What you're supposed to do, you're supposed to engage that brain in thinking positive. وإني الله سبحانه وتعالى speaking لغفار لمن تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا ثم اهتدى. الآية. You must engage. ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم told معاذ بن جبل أن وفي رواية أبي ذر اتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحوها. Follow a bad deed with a good deed right away. Engage in ta'at. And don't belittle a deed, akhi. لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. Do not belittle any deed. Even if you meet your brother with a smile. Assalamu alaykum, brother. That's a good deed. ولا أن تأخذ بدلوك. That you take some water from your bucket and give it to someone else. Water is free. And remember, a woman who used to be a prostitute went to Jannah because of giving a drink to a dog. وَرَجُلْ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. And a man, Allah forgiven his sins because he removed a harmful object from the street. لَا تُحَقِّرًا. أنت لا تدري أي حسنة تأخذك إلى الجنة. You don't know which one. Don't be little. Don't say this is a little deed. I'm not going to do it. Let me go for the big ones. لا. Four, engaging in hasanat. Five, the tawbah must take place before two events. The angels of death are here, or the sun rising from the west. There are some times, by the way, that will happen in earth when your tawbah will not be accepted. Inna Allah, hadith Umar ibn al-Khattab, wal hadith fil musnad wa sunan al-Tirmidhi, inna Allah yaqbalu at-tawbata min 'abdihi ma lam yughargir, aw kama qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات حتى إذا حضر أحدهم الموت قال إني تبت الآن. And tawbah is not for someone who keep committing sins until the angels of death are here. He will say what? I'm repenting. زي الفرعون كده الفرعون حتى إذا أدركه الغرق قال آمنت أنه لا إله إلا الذي آمنت به بنو إسرائيل وأنا من المسلمين. Until drowning came to him, he said, now I believe. Yeah. Look what, الآن now, لا. The second case, طلوع الشمس من مغربها, the sun rising from the west. يوم يأتي بعض آيات ربك لا ينفع نفسا إيمانها لم تكن آمنت من قبل أو كسبت في إيمانها خيرا. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح مسلم الحديث أبي موسى رضي الله عنه, إن الله يبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار ويبسط يده بالنهار ليتوب مسيء الليل حتى تطلع الشمس من مغربها. Allah will accept your repentance, whether you committed at night, during the day, until the sun rises from the west. Five conditions: sincerity, regretfulness, giving up the sin, engaging in obedience, doing it before the time of death and the sun rising from the west. أضاف أهل العلم شرطا آخر. There is one more condition. If that sin has to do with the rights of others, you must give the rights back. You must. You see, you go and steal somebody's money, cheat him out of his money. Oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, forgive me. La, go and give him his money back. That's how you repent from this one. The rights of the people, if you do not give it in this world, it will be taken out of you in the day of resurrection. حتى الغيبة يا أخي, even backbiting, it will be taken حسنات out of you in the day of resurrection. Forgive back the rights to the people. It's your call, my أخي, my brothers, my sisters. It's your call. Ramadan is here. You know what you're engaged on. These are major sins. Ramadan will not work if you're insisting on it. If you want to fast with these sins, you have the amanah. It's your responsibility. Make the call. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل, وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in 5 minutes or so, that's the time I have, I want to share with you a story of a killer. A killer. وَالْقَتْلُ فِي دِينِنَا, and killing in our religion is a great sin. A great sin. أَوَّلُ دِيوانٍ مِنَ الْمَظَالِمِ يُفْتَحُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ دِيوانُ الْقَتْلِ. The first record, the first injustice that will be dealt with in the day of resurrection is killing. وهذا وارد في حديث عبد الله بن مسعود وهو في الصحيحين, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم أول ما يقضى بين الناس يوم القيامة الدماء. To the extent that the scholars debated, هل للقاتل توبة Is the killer has a tawbah? Can he repent? سئل ابن عباس عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما سئل هل للقاتل توبة؟ Does the one who kill has a توبة؟ قال ثكلته أمه. May his mother lose him. يأتي المقتول يوم القيامة يحمل رأسه بين يديه ويجر قاتله ويقول أي رب سل هذا فيما قتلني. The killed will come in the day of resurrection carrying his neck on his hand. He will walk headless, carrying his head on his hand and grabbing his killer. Oh Allah, ask him why he killed me. This is not only for a believer, akhi. For a non-Muslim, for a kafir. Wallahi, hada fi deenina. Wallahi, this is in our deen. The religion that they accuse of all of these things. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من أمن معاهدا ثم قتل فأنا بريء منه وإن كان المقتول كافرا. الحديث في التاريخ الكبير البخاري ومعجم الطبراني حديث صحيح الإسناد حديث عمرو بن الحمق الخزاعي رضي الله عنه. If you give someone a covenant of security that would apply to you coming to America with a green card, that's a covenant of security, and you betray that person, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will disclaim you in the day of resurrection, even if the killed is a kafir. هذا هو الدين. جريمة عظيمة. أمر الدم عظيم في ديننا. ولا نقول هذا إرضاء لأحد. We don't say this to appease people. أخي هذا دين. هذا ديننا. This is what we believe in. فهذا الرجل والحديث في الصحيحين البخاري ومسلم حديث أبي سعيد. This man killed 99 souls. سبحان الله. After killing 99 souls, Allah سبحانه وتعالى wanted him to repent. ذلك لا تيأس. إياك. Dare you give up. والله يا أخي لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء. If your sins عمر بن الخطاب one day he was standing with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and they looked at a woman carrying her baby. والحديث في البخاري, you know, breastfeeding him, suckling him, suckling him. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أتظنون أن هذه المرأة طارحة ولدها في النار. You know the relationship of a mother and a daughter or an infant. Do you think this woman can throw her baby in the fire? Impossible. قال والله, by Allah, Allah is more merciful to his servants than this mother to her baby. Allah wants you back, akhi. Allah is not your enemy. Shaitan is your enemy. Allah wants you back. Even if you have done what you done, don't despair from the mercy of Allah. Allah can turn your lives around. Allah can make out of you someone else, but come back to him. He calls upon you. Come back to me. Come back to me. Here is a killer, 99. 99. They directed him to someone who is not knowledgeable of the deen. He asked him, do I have a chance? And here is someone who makes people despair from the mercy of Allah because he does not have the knowledge. He told him, no way. After killing 99 people, no way. No way. You know what he did? He pulled the sword and he killed him. Imagine if we don't have a chance to come back to Allah. This earth will be corrupt because you have no chance. He went back to the society, living his life. And again, Allah called upon him. Allah wanted him to repent again after killing 100 souls. 100 souls. This time he asked for a scholar. For a scholar. I want a scholar. I want someone who knows the deen. Not everybody who performs acts of worship know the deen. Not. No. لا تغتر. Don't look. Don't be deceived by the appearance. No. The religion is قال الله قال رسول الله. Allah said, the messenger said, this is the deen. Not I think أنا أرى وهذا يرى. I see and you see. لا. We all see, but let's take from the deen. He went to the scholar. He presented his case to him again. Do I still have a chance? He told him, وَلِمَ لَا? Why not? وَمَنْ يَحْجُبُ عَنْكَ بَابَ التَّوْبَةِ? Who can prevent you from repenting? But here is what you need to do. Leave that place. If you want to repent from the major sins, leave the friends who take you out to the clubs, to gambling, to drinking. Leave that place and go to that place. And the only good thing about this place, فَإِنَّهُمْ قَوْمٌ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. Those are people who do righteous deeds. He did not delay a second. Inshallah, 2 minutes. He did not delay a second. Immediately, he started traveling. He did not delay. Don't say, I'm going to have an extra Ramadan. Akhi, you don't know. Wallahi, people that we thought they're going to be with us this Ramadan, they are under the ground. You could be the same. Why? كبير على الموت انت يعني? You could be the same next year. This could be your last Ramadan, to say the least. Almost halfway, he dies. Now two groups of angels came to take his soul. Angels of mercy and angels of punishment. And they started quarreling. He belongs to us. The man killed 100 souls. He did not even make one hasana. One hasana he did not. All what he did is he walked some steps. The others say, no, innahu kharaja yanwi tawbah. He wanted out his heart intending to repent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent an arbitrator. He told them, measure the distance between origin, destination. Find out if he has traveled more than half the distance. If he did, then he goes to Jannah. If he did not, then he goes to the hellfire. Brothers and sisters in Islam, they found him short this much, 2 inches, whatever you want to call. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded earth, أنت قاربي, scoot over, so that he gets to go to Jannah. And he went to Jannah. And he did not do one righteous deeds. But you know what he went? What he did? He repented with his heart. I know a lot of you are sitting here skeptical. How can I live my life without that sin? I'm used to drinking. I'm used to gambling. I'm used to watching this haram stuff. I can't live. Akhi, wallahi, أصدق الله يصدقه. Be truthful with Allah. Like this man, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deliver you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deliver you. I leave it to you. Ramadan is only 12 days away from here. If you're engaged in a major sin, you can begin with this limb, with the heart. Intend to leave it and seek the means that within your capacity, and you will see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deliver you like he delivered this man. اللهم اكتب لنا قبل الموت توبة. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا إسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وارحمنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا عصاه فاغفر لنا يا أرحم الراحمين.
اللهم بارك لنا في شعبان وبلغنا رمضان أسألك رب العالمين أن نصومه وأن نقومه إيمانا واحتسابا حتى تغفر لنا ذنوبنا يا أرحم الراحمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.